Kim Kesty, Creative Director here at Fun Stampers Journey and Spellbinders, and I'm super excited to be back this month to reveal the July Stamp of the Month. So as you know, Spellbinders has a variety of kits that launch every single month, from dies to large dies, even a kit by the amazing paper grace Becca Feakin. But we also have a stamp set that launches every month, and that's what the video is all about today. Let's take a look at the July Stamp of the Month. This month is really, really fun and perfect for summer and all those fun occasions coming up. It is called, kind of punnily, the Age of Aquarium. So it's got all these wonderful, wonderful stamps that could go in an aquarium or any kind of nautical or beachy type card. It also has four super cute sentiments, 17 stamps in total in this set. Absolutely love it. There is a die that kind of is what I call a buddy die, so it's not necessarily a coordinating die that cuts out these shapes, but it really is perfect to match with this stamp set, and it's called the Aquarium Box Die. So I'm going to show this a little bit later. I'm going to set this aside for now, and I'll, again, bring that back later and show you some really fun things with it. But let's just take a look at the stamp set first, and I'm going to show you three different projects today that all highlight different ways to use this stamp set, and hopefully you will get the most out of your stamp of the month. So fun. Okay, so let's start with kind of a really basic background idea. I'm going to grab some sponges. These are our Fusion Ink sponges. A couple different shades of blue. Let's see, what do I want? We have so many shades of blue at Fun Stampers Journey, it's super fun to just mix and match any of the blue colors. I'm going to start with Pool Play, and this little panel right here is going to be the main panel of my card, but it's just small. It's 3 inches by 4 1/4, so I'm going to do some matting and some fun things in the background. So this is kind of a small panel to start with. What I'm doing is just sponging on some Pool Play ink. And so this is just going to kind of be the start of my watery background. I don't actually need a ton of this, and I don't even mind if some of the white spaces are kind of left in there. I'm going to come back with a darker blue later. So this is just kind of my first layer. There are so many fun things you can do with just watery effects in total. I love it. Now I'm going to take this and I'm going to bring in some of the stamps from this set. This first one is this really yummy, luscious coral. It's a pretty big coral. And that's this guy right here. So I thought, you know what? Let's run with it and do some really bright colored coral. This particular first ink is rich coral, as a matter of fact. So how perfect is that? So I'm just going to bring a few of these rich corals kind of in. I'm starting to create a little, I guess you'd call it a little scene. Fun little scene for my fishies. Maybe one down here. So I'm going to leave most of the middle somewhat blank so I can add some of the actual fish in there. I think we should do some orange coral too. This one, this ink is called Citrus Cooler. Hopefully I'm not going too fast with these inks. Sometimes I realize that I am familiar with all of the ink colors, but you might not be. Oh, look how pretty the orange is. Got some vibrant under the sea things going on. I totally don't mind if some of my ink, you know, stamps overlap. I think that's all the better because this kind of creates a lot of depth. Let's see, let me add a few more little fun greeneries to this. Let's grab this big old, this is kind of a seaweed looking thing, pretty fun. Let's do this a darker green. This one's Fresh Forest. And I might add some skinnier seaweeds too. But this, you notice that I'm gonna stamp this and I'm actually gonna go off the card panel. So I'm not trying to worry that, you know, the base of my seaweed is showing, so it's just kind of popping up in there. Again, this creates a lot of movement to your card, so there's one fun tip for you. Here's one of the long, skinny seaweed or sea life plants. I'm going to put one kind of coming in here, maybe another one here. Might even do one more little one coming in. Sometimes you don't need enough just to give that really, you know, playful look. All right, now I think I'm going to keep the Blue Lagoon and come back for my little school of fish. Now you could do any of the fish or the turtles or anything from this stamp set. There's so many cute options. But I chose just to do the school of fish for this one because I've got a lot of plans for the stamp set for a variety of ways to use all of the fishes. I thought it was something that was actually kind of fun with this fish set. The fins do go down, so I believe they are all swimming, kind of what I'm considering off to my left. But if you actually flip them around, the eye is centered such that you really can stamp it both ways. I am stamping it, so they're swimming to the left right now. But you totally could do it either way. I think that's pretty fun. So again, kind of getting it so some of my fish look like they're swimming out of the scene, and some are swimming into the scene. And maybe I'll pop this panel behind here just so you can kind of see where we're going with it without all the extra little scribbles. So now I love it. I kind of love how it's going. I'm leaving a little spot for my sentiment here, but I do want to bring in a little bit darker blue. So I'm going to grab my blue lagoon again, a little bit of a tongue twister there. And I'm coming in with my blue lagoon. And I'm just going to kind of start off the page a little bit and then kind of bring it into my edges. So when I'm sponging it, this really keeps the edge pretty soft. I'm going to first go mostly around all the edges. I don't have to go so much where the coral is, but definitely want to come in here. It's kind of dark blue down there. And then I'm also going to come in a little bit around some of my stamped images. Again, I don't have to worry about covering the entire thing, but I just kind of want to bring that really yummy darker blue look all the way around. Super fun. Now, last but not least, my fish need a few little bubbles, right? Because they need to be breathing. So I'll grab the little tiny bubble stamp here. Isn't this cute? Such a cute little one. Actually, I'm gonna grab one of my little blocks. Those of you who are familiar with me know that I love this little tiny block. This is our D block. It's one of our little tiny baby blocks. Anyway, one of my favorites. I like tiny stamps, so I can like use this little D block. So I'm doing pool play here, which doesn't show up a ton, but I think it will show up enough when I get my bubbles going on in here. Yeah, it doesn't show up very much. So let me do a few beach ball. Again, this is the joy of having all the different blues. Yeah, that's gonna be better. I don't mind that some of the pool play ones also show in there. That's fun. So again, just kind of adding your little bubbles to your card, having fun with that. So you can see that in just a matter of minutes, I've really created this fun little scene. I'll kind of, again, flip this over so you can see it. So just a lot of depth, a lot of action, just with that inking going on and different highlights and lowlights in your water. Super fun. Absolutely love it. Let me show you the card that is finished here, because it's got a really fun blue lagoon background, since that is the ink we used. It's really easy to create cards with the Fun Stampers Journey products because everything coordinates. It's so fun. So blue lagoon background, I've used a little bit of an embossing folder. Kind of catch it there in the video. Super fun, bubbly. And then just the simple sentiment right in the middle. So absolutely, I think it's a happy hello to send to somebody, especially someone who's fond of the ocean or the beach or any of those fun nautical things. So love that. Okay, I'll bring back that card at the very end. Let me just show one more card that I'm not gonna demo, but I couldn't resist this little guy just to show. We've also used an embossing folder here and kind of created a fun tunnel card. Kind of getting into these tunnel cards lately. I've done one with some of our new product that we're launching next week that's kind of in the starry night theme. But this is perfect for under the water too. So you can see that it's got three different layers, and both of these top two layers are embossed with our wood grain embossing folder. And then again, just layering the elements in there just make it really dimensional and fun. And there is a clear view sheet. You can kind of see that glistening there in the video. So it looks kind of like a fish tank, so cute. All right, so let me bring in another fun technique to show you. Better put the lid on my ink here, Kim. Okay, so what we've got here is I've got a beach ball piece of paper, but I've already added with a sponge some ink around the top. I thought I would just save a little bit of time. So I've added some of the beach ball ink right here, kind of already to this top edge, just because I want to kind of get that out of the way and also let it dry for just a few minutes to show you what I'm going to do next. Now I'm going to apply a really fun product that some of you are familiar with, maybe not everybody. This is called the Pan Pastels, and these are a product that we carry in colors that coordinate, again, with our products. This is the Party Pop set, so it comes just like this with seven different pans. There's six around and the one in the middle. And I love Party Pop because it has the white and the black. And both of these blues would be fabulous for any of the Stamp of the Month cards that we're going to be playing with now. But I'm going to show you a little technique with just the white pan pastel, and it's really cool. You also get this tool with your set of pan pastels, and I kind of call it a little slipper, but it is a tool and has extra little sponges. These are sponges especially made to work with a pan pastel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in. I can do this before or after I stamp. Actually, I think I'm going to stamp a couple things first. This is just to kind of give you an idea of how this is going to layer. Let me just add a couple stamps at the bottom. I won't do all of them. I'm going to do the fun little castle. I'm going to do just a couple little stamps coming in the bottom here so you can get the idea of this technique. Kind of stamping my castle a little crooked on purpose, yes. Probably wondering, Kim, what are you doing? Bring my seaweed back. And these are all just tone on toast, tone stamping. So I'm just doing all kinds of blues on top of the blue cardstock. And this is really just to kind of give the illusion that it's the bottom of my little fish tank. Let's see, I did this with beach ball too. So you could do any, you know, shapes or any of the fun little elements here. This is just to kind of give you the idea. The true technique is the one I'm showing with the pastels. So again, we have our white pastel. We have a little bit of inking at the top of this panel right here. Now I want to come in, I kind of want to give the idea that we've got like the rays of the sun or the rays of the light kind of coming into here to my card. So I'm using my slipper and I'm going to do my first sun rays coming out from the middle. And you notice that I'm kind of starting off the paper and coming in. The pan pastel is awesome. It blends really pretty. You don't have to have you know, any special artistic technique, although the pan pastels were originally a what I would consider a fairly artsy product. But I love that we can use it in our card making and really just have it really shine. I'm kind of just smoothing out these rays because I kind of want it to be just a little bit heavier look. But again, use the sponge to your advantage and just kind of work it. Get your angles. Maybe I want this angle a little bit more. And what's really cool about the pan pastels, if you get a piece that you don't like, you can take a white eraser and absolutely come in and just erase it. So that's really cool. I don't have a white eraser here, but if you get pigment where you don't want it, that's one super cool thing. We want to kind of have it on the edges here. And again, you can layer it. You can kind of let this set. The pan pastel will set in about 10 to 15 minutes, and then it will not rub off. So that's cool. You don't have to put any kind of fixative or anything on it. And again, you just come back and then add your other layers. You can stamp right on top of it, which is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to grab my bubbles back. And since I've got kind of the white pastel coming through here, I'm going to grab our whipped cream ink. And this is one of our pigment inks, so there's a little bit more pigment than our normal True Color Fusion inks. This also will take a little bit extra to dry, but I think that's fun. See how it really pops here? And of course I would add some fish and some other elements too, which I'll show you in the finished card. But I really love the idea that it's like the bubbly fish tank, and you're getting the idea that kind of looking in from the top right there. So that's enough dots. You can come back with as many as you want, but you can see already it's creating that fun depth and that fun illusion of really the fish tank with the light coming in toward the top. Let me show you the finished card with the sentiment and some couple of super bright happy as fish on top, and check it out. Really shows up nice once we add the white mat for the card, and of course we've accented it with a few of our little pearl elements. These are the pearls that we have by Fun Stamper's Journey, just the basic pearls. And look how fun, with a couple of the fish and then a couple of the bright fish popping up. Doesn't it look like the light shining through? Love it! Oh my gosh, so cute. Okay, gotta move along. I was trying to not make these videos so long, but somehow they end up being long. But that's okay. Hopefully you're getting some good tips and tricks here. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is one more background for you, and I'm going to use our liquid color, which is one of our favorite products. Perfect again for all these inky techniques. I'm just putting a little puddle on a clear block here. You could use a clear sheet or whatever you want. And now I'm bringing in a paintbrush. And this paintbrush is dry. It's one of our 1-inch just square paintbrushes. So I'm going to kind of hold it up real quick and see if I can not spray myself in the face here. I'm just wetting the end of it, and I'll put a little extra water on here. So what I want is I want this paintbrush to kind of separate. So when I wet it, I kind of want it to be separated like that, kind of clumped up, I guess you would call it, because that's going to give me the exact effect I want for my fun little streaks in my water. Now, I'm not really diluting this too much, just a little bit to make it work. And again, making sure my paintbrush is kind of separated there. Now, again, I'm going to come in from a point about here, and I'm going to bring in some fun sun rays. And I'm going to come back and fill in more of these, but I kind of want to give the idea that the sun is really flooding into this area of the ocean. I feel like this one's maybe not a fish tank. This maybe actually might be the ocean. I can tell I have all these scenarios in my head. So again, as you overlap the liquid color at the very top, it gets heavier, which is totally fine. That's what I want. Again, just coming in and adding more and more rays. Kind of, again, once in a while, making sure that your brush is kind of clumpy. Now you can come back and really do this for any length of time and just keep getting it darker and more streaky. Pretty happy with this so far. I am going to add one more layer on it. I love how it looks so far. You've really got that, you know, illusion that you've got the light coming in. But I am going to grab my clear sheet. These are the ones that come on the back of the stamp sets when you get them, so definitely save those and recycle those. I'm going to smush this leftover liquid color onto my sheet and spritz it with water. You can see that there's not tons in there. I've been kind of catching on the video there, but just enough to give me some water droplets. And that's exactly the look I want. I want it to look like good, heavy water droplets. Now I'm going to take this panel, and normally I would let this dry a little bit more. I could heat dry it if I wanted, because I want to keep the really look of those rays. But since I'm doing this in a little bit of a time frame, just going to kind of show you. I don't want super heavy blobs, so I'm trying to pick up the pieces that have got really the droplet-y looks. That's pretty cool. So you see how it's coming with kind of the droplets working in here? I think the first time I did it, I had finer drops, but again, it probably was because I let the panel dry before I did that second step. But pretty cool, right? I love how it looks. And when this dries, the liquid color dries slightly lighter than it's showing right here. So just kind of keep that in mind. And then when I add my effects of my different stamps on there, I'm going to do bring in the little castle and bring in, you know, some more fish and stuff. This time, because I wanted it real shadowy, I would stamp it in black licorice, which I will show you on the finished project right here. Sorry about that glare there. And take a look at this guy. So see how fun? Again, dries slightly lighter than the one I have right here. Then we've added some fun little dots with our journey glaze. So hopefully you can kind of catch a little bit of that dimension there. Ooh, nice close-up, Roy. Love it. So see the little bubbles with the journey glaze? Love those. And again, a couple of the brighter color fish. And the main parts of the background here are stamped in black. So it really kind of gives you just a shadowy look. And again, love this sentiment. Enjoy the little things. Such an appropriate sentiment. Absolutely love it. All right, so fun. So I'm going to show you the three cards that I kind of walked you through today, and then I'm going to show you a couple more samples because you know I can't resist. I love it so much. So there's the three different ideas for you for today, just to really get your juices flowing when you get Stamp of the Month in the mail. You can go just run with these techniques and have a blast recreating them or putting your own spin on them, of course. So let's show you a couple more extras. I did say that I wanted to show you something with the die, and I'm going to do that in a minute. But check this guy out. Fun shaker card, right? This is like the perfect card stamp set to make shaker cards. You can put all the little scenes inside and then add your little window with your sequins. Love that one. Here's one that the background is created with the gel press, and I absolutely love it. So we've got the gel press. We've just brayered. You can kind of see the brayer lines here. We've brayered color on the gel press and then just flicked some sparkle silk. And that absolutely gives you that yummy, dreamy background. Love that. And I love the circle just die cut here. Just, again, kind of reminiscent of a little fishbowl. So super cute. Here's another version of this first, second card, I guess, that I did. So look at this with the cool pool version. Isn't that fun? Love the darker. I think it really shows up with a darker blue, but it's really dreamy with a cool pool, too. This has got some of the fresh sage in it, too, in the ink. So love that combination. I had to show that one off. Okay, so let me get back to the box die just super quick and show you this guy. So this is the aquarium box, and it looks kind of a little crazy here, a little bit hard to understand. But let me show you some projects we made with it. Let me grab just the die alone. So here's the actual die that is just created as, again, this is like a shaker card. So you've got these fun little pieces that go across the top, and you can put those any way you want on the card. They're just little, I guess what I would call trim pieces. And this actual box creates the whole box. And you would cut two of these, and you can cut the window or not cut the window, whatever you want to do. So obviously the back does not have the window cut. The front does have the window cut. And then you would adhere it all together, you know, by folding the pieces. And then you can put any kind of scene inside and sequins and whatever. And you guys know that this size is absolutely perfect for a gift card. So it fits a gift card in there perfectly. So you also can slide that in, you know, in the back or make any kind of pocket. So love that on its own. Here's a fun project where we've flipped the trim a little bit. So now we have the trim coming down this way. A little bit hard to see on the black, but love adding that box to a card. Look, it makes this really fun dimensional card. So you can pop it right on the front of your card front, and then you have your scene inside. And again, using the clear view sheet is just perfect for this box die. Love it, love it, love it. All right, let me show one more card before I let you guys go. This is using another one of our products. This is our bubble stencil. So there's so many projects that Fun Stampers Journey has, so many different products that mix and match with the set that I think you guys are absolutely gonna go wild when you get it and have so much fun. So here it is, we just stenciled the background and again created this kind of smooshing technique for the little fishbowl and added our little fish, some of our sequins. Love it so much. So an amazing, amazing set. Let me bring the stamp set back in with all my fun projects. It's like a whole heap of projects here. So Age of Aquarium, July stamp of the month. I think you are absolutely gonna have fun with it. And as always, as you create your projects, please tag us at Fun Stampers Journey or Team Spellbinders, whether you post on social media or Instagram or Facebook or whatever, because we would love to see your projects. If you have any questions about kit clubs, visit us at funstampersjourney.com or spellbinders.us, where you can see all of the clubs. That's super fun. And in the meantime, enjoy your stamp of the month for July. And as always, I hope that you enjoy bringing paper to life.